Hi, Vonna Cadaver here at the San Fernando Valley Comic Book Convention. I'm here with Dustin Ferguson, and you've got a new movie out on Redbox. Tell me all about it.
It's called Nemesis 5. It's a sequel to the films produced by Albert Pune. I just came out to Redbox. It's about the end of the world and what hopefully doesn't happen to humanity.
I think it's going to happen.
I think it's going to happen, too. Sadly.
So the entire premise?
Basically, it's part 5 in a series of 4 films. It's about the Redbox hammerheads that now control everything. They're sort of like the anti-government, so there's a regime that's been risen by Skyler Craig, who's our lead in the film, who took over the reins from Sue Price, who's in the first 4 films. And basically, she's just kind of fighting for humanity. She has to use her powers, which is now human and cyborg. It's like they fuse together in the future. So she has to use those powers to overthrow the government and restore humanity.
So where did this, where did the idea come from? Was it a dream?
Actually, I ran a video store in Nebraska one day and had the posters for Nemesis 2 and 3 hanging in my store. And I started daydreaming. I'm like, you know, I want to make a part 5. And I love the series. It really was.
Yeah. Cool. So you've done a lot of movies. Silent Night, Deadly Night. Some of the projects that you've worked on. Tell me about those.
Yeah, just finished my 60-second feature film. I've done over 80 music videos.
Just a few.
Yeah. I'm most known for the Camp Blood 4 and 5 that I did. And Silent Night, Deadly Night 2. I've done a whole slew of films. I've done 7 films in just the last year and a half that I've been here. So we have a new one starting up called Los Angeles Shark Attack. But we start shooting in May.
So how is that rigorous schedule for you? I mean, how do you kind of juggle that?
I wouldn't have it any other way. Yeah. I mean, it's my life. It's what I like to do. If I'm not working hard, then I don't think I'm doing my job.
Yeah, and you love what you do.
I absolutely love what I do. I mean, this is an addiction. I'm an editor, I'm a director, I'm a producer. As long as I'm in the industry doing what I love, I'm happy.
Yeah, I was talking to one of the celebrity attendees earlier, and he was saying, you know, he wanted to be in horror when he was young, like he knew at a young age. So when did you know that this is what you wanted to do? You wanted to produce movies and create movies?
Very young age. In 5th grade, I wrote a Child's Play 4 script, if that tells you anything. Big fan of horror my whole life growing up. I mean, I went on to open a video store and eventually direct my own films. Like I said, over 60 films, I'm almost on 4%.
So what is your favorite horror?
The original Texas Chainsaw Massacre from 1974.
Oh, nice. Okay.
It paved the way for the genre.
It did. It's a classic, and it's the consummate.
It is, definitely.
So, where can we find your information on social?
Yes, all over Facebook. I'm the only Dustin Ferguson on Facebook. And you can find me on Instagram as the only Dirty D, which is my rap name.
Your only, what is it?
The only Dirty D is my rap name.
I love it. And actually, are you really?
I really am.
Okay, so you know I'm going to do this to you. Oh, you know you can't just say that to Ivana and not do something. So just give me a little spit.
Say my name because I'm bad about it. Play this game because I'm bad about it. That's all I got.
That's all I got?
That's all I got.
All right. Okay, cool. Hey, I'll take it. Like most people don't have the guts to do it, so I appreciate it. So, Dustin, is there anybody that you haven't worked with that you want to work with?
We're trying to link Danny Trejo right now for the short film. So that's someone I've kind of always wanted to work with. He's in all the great films. So I'd say that he's my number one right now.
He's so fantastic.
Really?
Sober, clarity, awesome.
Yes, I edited a film he was in by a key of Hong Kong, Round the Head, Last Chance. So I kind of had a connection to him there. We're using our connections to try to make it happen.
Awesome. And we spoke a little bit about the next movie you have going on. Let's talk a little bit more about that. Show me that poster.
It's called Los Angeles Shark Attack. Our whole campaign is to make sharks scary again.
Yeah.
So we're going to have three-headed sharks flying through the air in tornadoes. We're going to have people at the beach being murdered by sharks. It's going to be pretty awesome.
Listen, there's some real shit going down with these sharks. I mean, in real life. You know, like, I think the sharks are getting angry. I think the animals are getting angry, and they're kind of revolting.
That's exactly what the film's about.
Yeah. I mean, seriously. Like, when I saw Planet of the Apes last one, I was like, oh, it's on. Like, you know, like, the animal community is like, oh, we got
it. They got it, so yeah. It's their turn.
So that's kind of the inspiration behind the movie.
Yeah. Overpopulation, pollution in the ocean. They're getting their revenge. It's time.
And anything else that you're working on, like, you have any more time in your life?
Sure. Well, we just finished The Night of the Demons and Police Academy documentaries. Those are going to be coming out later this year. And we wrapped Robo-Woman. We're starting Robo-Woman 2 later this year, too, also. So got a good 4 or 5 movies coming out.
So, do you have time for lunch?
I took time out of my lunch to do this interview, actually. So, no, I don't have time for my lunch.
Okay. Well, you have a good time. It was great.